Hi, I'm Adam Spires, and I'd like to show you a quick demo of how to use the git-deps tool that I've built to backport a git commit or series of commits from one branch to another. So the git-deps tool is here on GitHub. If you haven't seen it already, it might be worth you watching this YouTube screencast demonstration first before watching the rest of this video. It's only about 10 minutes long. And it explains a bit of the background theory and the motivation for the tool. But in this video, we're going to focus on this use case, porting commits between branches. And to do that, I'm going to use the example of porting a bug fix from the master branch of this project back to a stable branch. So this project is called CRM Shell. It's a high availability component in the Linux HA world. And so we have the master branch here, and if we scroll back, then one of the recent commits in the master branch is this one here, and I've tagged it with this to pick tag. So that's the one that we want to backport. And if I launch this git k command here, then we can see the overall structure of the project's history. What this simplify by decoration option does is suppress the showing commits which aren't decorated, so they're not tagged or have a branch associated with them. So we just get an overview of the whole history of the project. So if I do that, focusing on the upstream master branch, the to pick tag that I've just created, and also the stable branch that we want to backport to, then we can see the structure. So here's the master, which is obviously the latest commit. Here we've got the one that we want to backport, and then going way back here, we can see the stable branch is from the version 1.x series. So the latest 1.x is 1.2.6. So that's where we're going to backport to. So what I'll do is I'll create a new branch called stable, pointing to that 1.2.6, and I'll check it out. And so now we're ready to start backporting from this to pick commit. So if I just try a straight cherry pick of to pick, then we get a conflict. So it's not going to be as easy as we'd like, unfortunately. So we just set that branch back to how it was before. And now we're going to use git-deps to make the cherry picking process more straightforward. So the first thing I want to do is get a feel for what are the dependencies of the commit that we want to pick into to cherry pick into the stable branch. So I can do this with the git-deps command to launch the web server, which is minus s. But what I want to do is exclude from the visualization of the dependency tree anything which is already in the stable branch, because if the commit that we're trying to cherry pick has dependencies that are already in the stable branch, then we don't need to cherry pick those. We only need to focus on the dependencies which aren't already in the stable branch. So that's why we have this minus e to exclude all commits in the stable branch from the visualization. So that launches the server. Let's then go to the web interface, and we'll look at the dependencies for the commit that we want to pick. Okay, so this is the commit we want to pick. You can see on the right-hand side of the tooltip there, it says to pick. That's our tag, and we can see it depends on this one here. So this is another commit in the state that isn't yet in the stable branch, but the commit we want to cherry pick depends on it. So we know this is telling us we need to cherry pick this one before we can cherry pick that one. But this also needs to be checked for dependencies in turn. So if we click on plus here, then we find another dependency, which is again not in yet in the stable branch. And if we click that again, we see no new dependencies found. So at this point, we know these are the only two dependencies of the commit that we're trying to backport. So that's useful information, and we can start cherry picking straight away. Now, actually, in this case, it might be simpler. It's quite nice to visualize it in the web interface sometimes, but on other occasions, it's just easier to use the command line interface from git-deps. So we can do the same thing without the minus s. And we also need a minus r to do recursive dependency checking, which is the equivalent of clicking the plus, all the available plus icons in the graph. It will just do that automatically. And again, we want to exclude any commits that are already in the stable branch. And then we just do to pick. And that's it. So if we do git rev pars of to pick, then this is the one we're trying to backport, so we see that commit corresponds to this one here. So the output format of the command line tool is the first column is the commit that is depending on the one in the second column. So this commit depends on that one, and that one depends on that one, and you can see that these two are the same as well, so that's basically representing the same chain of dependencies between three commits that we saw in the graph. So working backwards, we want to cherry pick this one, and then this one, and there are ways of automatically calculating the output so that we could pipe that directly into cherry pick, but in this example it's simple enough that we can just do it manually. So at this point I can just do git cherry pick. Minus x is always nice because it shows where we've cherry picked it from in the commit message. So we want this one, then this one, and then this one, and there you go, it's all cherry picked cleanly. We can go back to the history and hit reload. Actually, when this git k is confined to just that particular branch, so if we just run it with stable, then there we go, we can see this is the stable branch and here are the three commits that we've backported, and we can see that each one references where it came from. So that was pretty easy. I hope that gives you an idea of one of the use cases of git-deps. I hope you find this tool useful.